Hello friends and everyone, you're welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. In this video, we are going to talk about how to integrate map in .NET Maui application, focusing on the Android application or Android phone. Now, for Windows, we can do that later because Windows does not support the current way of integrating map. But for Android, it does support, so we're going to talk about using the Android. Maybe later on we're going to have a video on how to integrate Bing map in Windows application or desktop application. So I made a video on how to get an API key. So this API key that I have here was done by a video, and I put the link under the description. So if you don't know how to get an API key from Google Maps, then you can watch that video and get how to grab an API key. So let's assume you've watched that video or you know how to get an API key. So create a new key from the cloud.console or console.cloud.google.com and grab your key. So with this, there are procedures or ways to integrate map. You know, we can open native map on the Android phone or desktop application. I've done that video too, how to open the native map. So I'll put the link under the description too. By this video, we are going to talk about how to open the map in our application. So when you read the documentation for map integration, let's start from here. That is a map. So when you go to learn.microsoft.com and .NET Maui user interface controls, then search for map, and that is over here. You can have this article. Now with this, there are a lot of things that you need to consider when integrating map in Android application. We are going to go for the basics. Maybe you can read more for the advanced ones. So first of all, as you can see here, there is an important note that we have to read. Now this is saying that the map control isn't supported on Windows due to lack of map control in WinUI. That's a Windows user interface. However, the community toolkit.maui.map package provides access to Bing map. So here, the one that we're going to do currently does not support in desktop. The package that we can use to support it is the community toolkit.maui.maps. We're going to have a separate video on this. Let's focus. So to set up this, there are several ways. So we first have to install this. So, and this is provided by the microsoft.maui.control.map package. So we have to grab this package and now install. As I speak, I have my project created and run in that's the emulator. So as you can see from here, I have this application. Let's go to the source code. I'm going to stop debugging. Then let's install this package. So make sure you are also connected to internet as well. Then click on the browse, and now in here let's paste the package name. So let's install this package. So after installation, what is the next thing to do? We have to add this use Maui apps. So let's copy this. I'm going to do that in the Maui program.cs file. So let's apply and accept it. So this is done. When you check dependencies, when you check the Android and packages, you're going to see it over here, maui.control.maps, and that's what we have. Let's go to my program.cs file and add this use name. So use Maui maps, and now this is going to add a namespace. So let's make this the change over here. So we have to clear this up, and let's see if we need to use any extension or namespace. Okay, so it's already included. Now, the next thing that we can do here from this is we have to add a platform configuration. If you're using iOS and Mac Catalyst, then you have to do this. So you can add this to your info p list, and your info p list is when you come to the platform, you click on the iOS, and you see we have the info p list. So you right click and you have to open with XML editor. So XML editor, let's choose this, then open. So you have to add that over here. So using the namespace, you have to add it over here, like what we started. Okay, so when using the Mac, you can go to this and I'll grab all this and now you paste it over here. But currently we are focusing on the Android, so if you want to use the Mac, you do the same. That's very simple. Let's go to the Android. So here under the configuration, we have to perform this process. The first one here is you have to get the Google Map API key and add it to our app manifest. Aside from that, you have to specify the Google Play service version number in the manifest. Why do you have to do that? We talk about that. And the third one here is specify location permission in the manifest. And the last one, specify the right external storage permission in the manifest. Now the third and the fourth one, they are optional. You can decide to do that because it is based on a specific API service. So maybe if it is lower than API service of 21 or maybe Android version 9.0 or 10 or 11, maybe you need to do that. But from 13, maybe it is okay. That's why you have this optional. So if you know the target that you are doing or the range of your framework that you are doing for, then you can decide to choose whether to add this optional one or to exclude it. Now let's get an API key. So to get an API key, you know we have done that already. So we have to do this. Now you see we have to add this to our, let's copy this, let's go to our project and let's Android manifest. Let's open also this in XML editor, and now in here we have to add this metadata in it. So you see this is a manifest file and we have permissions over here. We have this application and in here we are going to paste this. So you have to paste our API key, and now when you check this, it is saying we have the application and we have all this, and let's paste. So in here, the name over here is not going to be overridden, but the value here has to be overridden. So we go to our credentials page, we copy our API key, then we come here, we clear this, and now we paste the API key here. So this is an API key. Aside from that, the next thing that we can do from this, the documentation is, the second part is we have to specify the Google Play service version in the manifest. So if you check here, now this is just an explanation to this API key name and the value. So maybe you can just read about this. Now let's specify Google Play service version. So we have to add the following declaration within the application element of the Android manifest. So all this, we have to copy this and I add this to the Android. So let's grab this, and in here we have to also add this. When we are done with that, we have to specify permissions. So permission to access our location, and we can grab this permission from here. So let's grab this permissions and let's go to our app. Now in here you see we have access network state and internet. So this one too, let's paste this, and that's the location permission. Now the next thing that we want to talk about here is we have to specify right external storage permission. So it is saying that why do you have to do that? If your app target API 22 or lower, it will be necessary to add the right external storage permission to the manifest as a chart of the manifest element. So when your target API it is 22 or below, then you can use this. If you want to know the API 22 or below, we go to the settings, we click on tools, Android, and we can go for the SDK manager. Now when you wait for this to launch, it's going to tell us that when you click on tools, API 22, let's see. So API 22, that is for Android version of what, 5.0? So 5.1 and below. So if you're using 5.5, your version, or if your application targets the 5.0 of Android and below, then you have to include that. So let's include it. Let's go to our documentation, and now let's grab this. Let's go to the program. That's the program here, and permissions, we have to add it to the manifest file. Okay, so we can now save all this. The next thing that we can do here is to add a map control. Now within map control, there are some attributes that we can talk about. These are the appearances and the behavior that this map exhibits. We have a showing user, and here it is a bool item source over here. So you can read through all this. We're going to focus about this is traffic enabled, scroll enabled, a zoom enabled, map type, and let's say maybe pins or visible or region. So to do that, we have to add this namespace to the content page. So let's grab this and let's go to our project. And now here where we have this main page.xml file, we open this and let's add this to the namespace here. Aside from adding this to the namespace, what we can do again is to add the map. So let's grab this map and let's clear all this because you don't need this. So we can comment this. And now let's paste our map here. So this is our map. We have a name given as map. Now let's save this. Let's run it in the application and see what we have now. So you can see that the map is now loaded, and we have the default one is Maui. There are a few things that we can also do. Now there is an equivalent C# code if you want to use a C# code to do that. So you can add a namespace and you create an instance of the map, and you set the content of this page to the map object that you've created. And this will be the outcome of it. So the default one is in the Maui land. As you can see, the map over here, this is the default one when you run this application. Now, so there are a few things that we can talk about. The first one is the map types. So map types, there are three types. You have street. So this specifies that a street map will be displayed. So strip by strip. We also have satellite. If you want to have a satellite image, then you can do the satellite over here. Or if you want to combine the satellite and the street, then you have to go for the hybrid. So you can do that with this. So you can just satellite. Let's go to the map. And now in here, what we have our main page. Now this map, you can specify the map type. So we have map type, and you can set to the hybrid or any. Aside from that, there are also, let's talk about the next one. We can also talk about displaying a specific location. So with the displaying, you know, we have to also add this to the namespace. So we can add this essential to the namespace to grab the current content or the current location. So we copy this, then we go to the display, then we add this, the sensor. So let's add this namespace. So we have this maps object, because we have this map which holding the namespace over here for the controls. So once you're done, you know, when you come here, we can specify the map. And now here we need to specify an argument. Now in this argument, we specify the map span, and within the map span, we have to also specify an argument. So as you can see, the map control needs an argument. Now the argument contains the map, whereby this map also contains an argument, and now this argument contains the sensor. So the sensor here, it is for where you have the location, because you want to grab the location. And the sensor also contains an argument, and here we pass in the double, that's the latitude, and we pass in the longitude. Okay, and the same thing applies to this. So we pass in the latitude and the longitude to get us the current location. So we can do that. And also, this is also the way of doing it in the C# code. So the result will be like this. So you're going to have a specific place that you want to display, and a data or a location. Okay, so there are a lot of things that we can actually read through. There's also one thing that we want to talk about. It's also known as from the controls. You know, we can talk about a showing user. So when you set a showing user to true, it means it's going to get at the current user's current location. So let's also add that to the map. So a showing user. So we can set this to true or false. And also, as you can see, we have another list. So you can see we have, is it visible? Also, when it scrolls down, you can see we have a lot over here that we can actually use. Let's say is a scroll enabled, is traffic enabled, is zoom enabled. So all these, you can set this to true. So this, when you set this zoom to true, user can zoom the map. Now let's set traffic. So we're going to show up the current traffic and the free areas in it. So we can do that too. And the next one we can also add is scroll enabled. So here user can scroll and see. So let's set this to true. Okay. So you can see these are the controls that you can have in map. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like what I'm doing, you can give me a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel too. We have a lot of lessons and projects, so you can just go there and I'll check it up over there. Take care of yourself, and I'm going to catch you up in the next video.